Have you completed a puzzle? You know this puzzle? You know this little pieces thing? And with one single mistake, you will not be able to complete a puzzle. Have you played Lego? You know this little stopping order of things? And it's not a puzzle, because Lego you can put it anywhere to form an object, something. But a puzzle is not. You have to be precise to place one piece at a time and to make you successful. So each Christian is like a piece in a puzzle. Each Christian is a piece of brick that is used to build a spiritual house. Each piece of brick holds its weight. So like those bricks there, then of course there is a purpose, because each brick is holding the other, because so that they'll be strong and there's enough strength in that. So each Christian has a sphere of responsibility, and you can serve the Lord in your own way, which we have studied a few months ago during the seminar, isn't it?
In finding the gifts of God to us.
Okay. So the good news is, each piece of brick in a building is essential and serves a purpose. Now the question is, what is your purpose at church, in the ministry? You have. Don't ever tell God, or yourself, or anyone, or your pastor that you are useless. You have nothing to do for the kingdom of God, because that is not true at all. Okay. Now let's go to the next one. All right, my outline is missing page 5. Oh, it's here. Praise God. Okay, now coming stage, the serving process. Okay, so we have the feeding time, feeding process, feeding time, and the growing time, the building up, and we have the serving process, which is the falling stage. And in verse 9, can you display up in place verse 9? But you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession, that you may declare the praises of Him who called you out of darkness into His wonderful light. Take note of the word you are. You are. You are. The Lord is talking to you. You are. You are. You are. Okay? So we will concentrate on God. You are, the words you are, is a declaration of a responsible position. It is an appointment. Okay? So when the Lord is has worked in your life to become Christian and saved, then automatically the Lord will say, you are a new creation. You are a holy nation. You are God's people. You are a chosen generation. So you are is a vocation, is a divine call to God's service or Christian life. So that when the Lord says you are through His word, don't tell Him that no I'm not. You are, no I'm not. You are, I told you Lord, I'm not, I will not go to death. Alright? But the Lord is so too stubborn, saying that, believe it or not, you can do it just like what he said to Moses. I can do it, I cannot talk. Alright, well, you can do that. You can. No, I cannot talk. Alright, okay, your brother will accompany you and later do the talking. And he did the talking later on. And so Isaiah was, the Lord was telling to him, who can I serve? Send. And then Isaiah, the Lord, heal my send me. Okay, I had a beautiful testimony on this. You know, this is the Philippines, the Christian Broadcasting, the founder, before it all started, was a tower mechanic. You know, the tower for the radio frequency, those things, mechanic. There was lightning. And because of the lightning, it hit the tower, and he got stuck. The ear of the guy, got the technician, he was doing fixing something on the tower. He got his ear stuck in the tower, and he was hearing. He was hearing the program, the radio program. And the radio program was saying, who can And then he said in his heart, send me Lord. But his ear was stuck in the tower. And then he was used in the radio station. Right. So are you waiting for me to be hit by a thunder or by a lightning before you can say, the Lord, yes, Lord, I am. No, you're not. Oh, no, I'm not. Yes, I am. Praise the Lord. So who can say, I am? Raise your hand and say, I am.
I am.
Oh, I'm still not impressed. Maybe I'm just pushing a bit. All right, let me push a little bit more. One, two, three, say, English standard version ESV. So meaning that we are born in this race, in this generation, 21st century. I mean, we are living in the 21st century, and we are glad that we are here because we can see the power of the Lord, the ministry of the Holy Spirit. We can understand the Word of God like the Old Testament people. They don't know what's happening. They don't know what about the Holy Spirit. They don't know about the salvation that Jesus is saying. They don't know about the church. While us, we are in the tower, not being hit by a thunder, but we can see from Genesis to Revelation that we can see the plan of God because we are a chosen generation. We are a chosen race. And you might say that, Lord, I wish I was born during the time of Jesus that I would see his miracle. I tell you, maybe if you were born during this, those times, you were one of those saying, crucify him, crucify him. All right? That's fun, isn't it? So we belong to a chosen. Born and living in the 21st century with iPad, iPhone, Samsung, and parents, iPhone, and all those stuff. But praise the Lord. Amen. There is for some purpose. Now, you are a royal priesthood. Priest, being priest means signifies headship, nobility, belonging to the lineage of the king. A priest represents the people to God. Alright? Prophet represents God to the people. That's the difference. But we are called the royal, blue-blooded people. Royal priesthood, it means that you are representing people to God. This is what we're studying about being ambassadors of Christ in our Friday Bible study. So Peter is saying here that you are a royal priesthood, meaning you can intercede. You can pray for people, whether Christians or non-Christians, to the Lord, because we have that a position in the eyes of God that we are priests. Well, of course, the high priest is Jesus Christ because he's interceding for us. And we can also intercede for the church, for the pastors, for the members, for the unbelievers, because we are royal priesthood. Then it says also that you are a holy nation. Well, you are holy, you are purchased by the blood and cleansed by the blood of the Lord. You were not purchased by Bill Gates, who is the richest man on earth. You were not purchased by something like the biggest diamond in the whole world, but you are purchased by the blood of Jesus, the most precious item here on earth. The blood of Jesus, you are purchased by him, and so you become a holy nation because he gave his life. He poured out his blood just to purchase us, because that's how he loves us. And then you are God's special possession. Alright? How many of you here have something, be honest, something that you cannot devour, like material, like a pin or a belt? How old is it? A pair of shoes that, although they're already put, I don't know how to say that in English, no, it ran out of heels. Yeah. And you cannot give it up because it's a special possession. This was given to me. Handed down by my great-grandmother, so how can I give this up? That is how the Lord is to you. Because we are God's possession. No matter how good we are, no more healed, because full of trials, we cannot walk anymore. No matter how question. I own you. Can you contest that?
No, I'm not.
You will say, no, I'm not. Just say, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. In Psalm 8:3-4, when I consider that your heavens, David was praying here, not David. David the king. When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moons and the stars, which you have set in place, which is, or what is mankind that you are mindful of them, human being that you can care for them. You see that? David compared himself to the stars, the moon, to the planets. And David was saying, why are you mindful of me as a human being? I'm so small here on earth. And yet, you are so mindful of me. Well, the Lord could answer that, but it's not recorded in Psalms that you are my possession. Peter recorded that you are God's possession. Praise the Lord. And in verse 19, we just read verse 19. Once you were not a people, but now you are the people of God. Once you have not received mercy, but now you have received mercy. You see this? There's an adoption going on. The Lord re-adopted us. And because we are in a position of being adoptees, then we have special privileges that some natural children could not enjoy. Like the Jews, the Hebrew people. They don't have the Holy Spirit until they accept Jesus in their life. And so we have these benefits. We can pray for healing. We can pray for something miraculous to happen. We can pray for big things. We can pray for smoking. I remember my this person saying something like, why do you have to pray to the Lord when your needle is lost? That is a very small thing to pray for the Lord. Well, if you feel like praying for your lost leader or lost thread, do it. Because the Lord is God of big things and small things. Right? It doesn't matter, God. If it's as small as that or as big as those, it doesn't matter. The beautiful thing is we are a possession of God and we belong to Him. Alright? So to review the things to that. Yes. So we have the stage of salvation from birth to birth, feeding stage where we grow through milk, and building stage through trials, and we have the calling stage serving the Lord because we are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, and we belong to this generation, and we are a special possession of God. Let's give the Lord a big hand. Yes. Thank you, Lord God, for waking us up spiritually speaking.